Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Ford Listening Room at the Arc. My name's Jennifer, and I'm one of the night managers here. Thank you all for joining us for this month's Artist Spotlight Series, sponsored by our friends at Food Gatherers and the Ford Motor Company Fund. A special thanks goes out to all of you here tonight who are members of this great nonprofit music venue. We surely appreciate your financial support in making all of these evenings possible. And to everyone who's tuning in to our streaming at home, you can go ahead and show your appreciation and support for tonight's performance by clicking on the virtual tip jar, which you can find pinned to the comments section of the live stream. We would love to see you do that. The proceeds will be split evenly between the Arc and tonight's artists. Finally, there's another group of people tonight who we really need to thank, and that is our wonderful crew of volunteers that we have working here in our club tonight. They make it a great listening room experience. Give them a round of applause. And then finally, before we begin, just a couple quick house rules. Tonight's performance will be straight through, no intermission. Please do take a moment now to remember to silence your cell phones. And also remember that there's no recording and no flash photography. And with that, we are ready to begin. So please welcome to the stage, Stringfever.
Man here, Well, to me, he will always be my little cousin. There he is. 3 years younger than me, can you believe it? On viola and vocals. Make some noise for our cousin, Graham. And to this side of the stage, playing five-string electric violin, the sensational Sister Sophie.
Playing five-string electric violin, he is the debonair compere, who still has some hair, the pint-sized Brit, who's full of wit. It's Mr. Ralph
much. Thank you, too kind. That was, of course, Eleanor Rigby by the Beatles. Thank you. Now, for those of you that haven't seen our show before, let me tell you what happens. Now, this is the point where we like to involve you, the audience. Now, don't panic. All we're now going to do is test your knowledge of music from the movies. So our next number is some music taken from 20 well-known movies. All you have to do is try to name as many of these 20 movies as you can. In fact, if anyone here this evening can correctly name all 20 of these movies, after the show, they will be able to claim a very special prize. Terms and conditions apply. Stringfever cannot be responsible for the low quality of acting in this number. Drums can fall as well as rise. Is that clear? Now, I do warn you, 20 is going to be a lot to get through in what is going to be a short space of time. So we're going to help you, as always this evening, by giving you a few clues, a few hints as to what some of these movies are from the States. So watch carefully. Are we ready? Clue number one. These are a few of our favorite film tunes.
Together now.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So, number 15 was anyone? Now, I know there was a lot to get through there, so let's go over some brief highlights for you. We started off, of course, with The Sound of Music, followed by Star Wars. I think we all got the Pink Panther theme, followed by the James Bond theme, didn't we? Who got E.T.? Was in there. The Wizard of Oz. Mission Impossible, did he get that one? I think we all got Graham's clue for the Titanic, didn't we? Yes. It was like having Kate Winslet in the room with us, I felt. Two westerns, The Good, The Bad and The Ugly, earlier on, and then later on, The Magnificent Seven, whoever said that is correct. Hopefully that solves any debates later on. And for those of you that were interested, number 15 was a movie called The Deer Hunter. Yes, that's what that was supposed to be. That clue, and not as someone recently guessed, Bambi. I can see what they were thinking, but two very different movies, Bambi and The Deer Hunter. Don't get them confused when the kids want to put a DVD on. Now, a while ago, someone asked us if we could include some opera in our show. So, there are two problems with this request. Firstly, none of us here on stage can sing opera. No. And secondly, I don't know about you guys, but even though we quite like opera, I don't know about you, but we find it does go on sometimes, opera, a little bit too long. Do you find this? I'll tell you a true fact. Some of the German operas last 3, maybe 4 days. So we've come up with a solution. We now present for you the Stringfever Instrumental Opera Medley. in 5 minutes. Thank you. Thank you very much. That's more like it. That didn't take too long, did it? Incidentally, if you want to know the names of those 10 different operas we've just performed for you, let me tell you, they are printed on a list on the inside cover of one of our CDs, which, of course, you can buy at the booth afterwards. Hands up, anyone still owns a CD player? Anyone still got one? A few of you, one or two. Even if you don't own a CD player, they make really nice coasters, so you can buy one anyway. Now, the reason I mention the CDs is we have a special offer on today because we have 3 different CDs of our music and a DVD as well, if you want to see us. Today, any one item, $10. Any 2 items, $15. And today, if you buy 10 items, you get to take one of the band home with you. You might laugh, but there used to be a symphony orchestra behind me years ago. That's a lot of CDs. Now, here's a new piece that is new for this season. People that have heard us perform before won't have heard us play this particular piece. It's written by an American composer in the early 1980s, even though people often think it might be a traditional Scottish tune. It's in that style, but it was written in the early 1980s by Jay Unger, and I believe the story behind this is him and his wife used to run some fiddle camps. I think it was upstate New York. And they'd have everyone play music for a week. And at the end of it, he wrote this tune. It was a kind of mournful way of saying goodbye to everyone. They'd had this lovely week of making music. And so his wife named it the Ashoken Farewell. And so this is our arrangement of that particular piece. It really became famous, certainly in our country, I'm not sure about over here. In the 1990s, it was used in 2 different documentaries about the American Civil War. So this is now our arrangement of the Ashoken Farewell.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, tonight's show is show number 3 of our USA tour. This is the first time we've been in the USA for 4 years. We were due to do a tour here in the States in April 2020. Yes, you remember what happened then. We don't need any reminding. So it's taken us 4 years to come back, but we're thrilled to be here. This is the final show of our kind of Midwest section. Tomorrow we fly out to Montana. That was the bulk of the tour that was cancelled. But it's an absolute honor to be with you here this evening. This tour, in fact, I was counting up the other day, it's tour number 18 that Stringfever have done since 2008, 2020. I was counting up. We've now played in over 150 different cities across the USA. We've now performed our show in 37 different states. And just to make that clear, when I say we've performed in different states, I don't mean like half drunk, sober, half asleep. Geographical states, obviously, we're talking about. So we've picked up some of your great music on our travels in that time. We're going to play some more of it for you now. This was written and made famous many years ago by a man called Charlie Daniels. Yes, some of you out there may already know that the devil went down to Georgia.
When he came across this young man, son on the fiddle and playing it hot. And the devil jumped up on a hickory stump. Said, boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. And now you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his dues. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul, because I think I'm better than you. The boy said, my name's Charlie, and it might be a sin. But I'll take your bet, you're gonna regret, because I'm the best there's ever been. Johnny, rise up your bow and play your fiddle hard. Sells produce in Georgia, and the devil deals the cards. And if you win, I'll get this shiny fiddle made to go home. But if you lose, the devil gets your soul. The devil opened up his case, and he said, I'll stop this show. And fire flew from his fingertips as he rocked up his bow. And he pulled the bow across the strings, and it made an evil hiss. And a band of demons joined in, and it sounded something like this.
I'll just tell you a quick true story. We came off stage having performed our show in New York City just over 10 years ago. And I got chatting to an old lady after the show. And she said to me, I really enjoyed your show this evening. In particular, she said, I enjoyed The Devil Went Down to Georgia. Because, she said, Believe it or not, I am Charlie Daniels' mother-in-law. I didn't think to ask her at the time if she was the inspiration behind the song, given the reputation. I can only assume not. She seemed lovely to me. And now it's time for some music by a British composer. This was written by our uncle, who also plays the violin. We're lucky in our family come from a very musical family. The three siblings in the group are Dad, called Alan Broadbent, and his next younger brother down, called Stephen Broadbent, who was Graham's father. Of course, they were brothers. They both made string playing their profession, not only performing, but teaching as well. Our dad was a violin teacher. During his 73 years, he taught hundreds, if not thousands, of students. Many little kids from beginners. He had a really